Hello and welcome to the computer lab. So in this video I'm going to show you how to use green screen special effects using inbuilt free programs Keynote and iMovie on your Mac. Okay, so let's get started. Open Keynote up. And from the themes that we have the options for, we can either pick the black or white one. It doesn't really matter because we are going to change the color of it in a minute. So I'm going to choose the white one. And we then need to delete the two sections out in the middle. I'm just reducing it down to 75% there, just so you can see the section that we're working off for this particular video. So delete the two bits of predefined text out just by clicking on it and hitting the delete key. And now we need to decide on what size we are going to use. Now my video that I'm going to overlay this onto is 1920 by 1080 HD video. So I'm going to make my piece of work area exactly the same size. If you want to change yours, you can click on the document in the top right hand corner. You'll notice I'm currently set on widescreen. So if I leave it on widescreen and then click on custom size, you will see the size that it is defined at the moment, which is 1920 by 1080. So if you want to change that size, for example, if we want to run off the standard size, if I click on standard and then go to custom, it will show me the standard size, which is 1024 by 768. So I'll cancel that. So you can set a specific video size overlay in there. It's best to try and get this size how you want it, so you can get a scale of where the item that you're going to put into the video, where it's going to sit within your video frame. Okay, so I'm happy with the 1920 wide by 1080 high. So now I need to find a image that I can use. You might already have one that you've cut out or pre-cut out, or a photo you've taken, or a logo you're going to use. I'm just going to do a quick search on the internet for a free PNG that I can use. So I'm using a PNG because they have a transparent background. So I'm just going to look for something that says coffee time with PNG at the end of it. That's the file format that I want. Click on Google search and then also go and click on images. So we're searching within the images database. And also, because I'm using this on the video, its usage rights need to be able to be open. So all these ones that it's showing at the moment, these are somebody's property. So if we click on tools, make sure that we click on usage rights for this particular video, label for reuse with modification. So I want to reuse it, obviously, to create this video. There's a couple in here, and I think we'll probably go for that one that's right at the top of the list, the post-it note in yellow. Looks about the right size, 720 by 720, so it's clear enough. And I can tell by the checkered background that this is a PNG. So right click and then save image as. See where it's going to save. It's going to save it into pictures. I'll just get rid of this bit at the end and just make sure it just says coffee, just so I can see it in my Finder window. Pictures, it's going to save as a PNG. Click on save. Wait for it to download. And then minimize that window. Okay, so now I need to drag that into my work area. So open Finder Backup, find out where you have saved it, click on pictures in my case, and then I'm going to drag this PNG onto my work area, like so. And you can resize this and put it exactly where you want. And this is why it's quite important why you got that 1920 by 1080 in my case, because that's the video size I'm going to overlay this on. So I have a rough idea of what it's going to look. The video that I have done has a coffee cup steaming on the right-hand side. So I'm just working on this logo on the left-hand side and make sure it's about the right size, which you'll see in a minute when I overlay this onto the green screen and the video that I'm going to put it on. So the next thing is to animate the PNG that we've just put onto our work area. So up to the top right-hand corner, click on animate. We have a couple of options there, build in, action, and build out. So the one I'm going to work on first is the build in. So this is the thing that's going to happen first. So we have lots of different options in Keynote, different animations. We have move in, and you can preview by clicking on the little preview icon, and you can preview one of the other ones, for example, until you find one that you like. Once you find one, just actually click on the actual action itself, and then you can change what you want it to do. So for example, this one bounces once it's finished the move in. Click on preview, you'll see it bounce at the end of its left to right movement. So I'm happy with that, leave it as it is, and I'll click on action. So this is the middle action that it's going to perform. So again, I've got a couple of options in here. This is the, once it's actually done its first, this is the second thing it's going to do. So you can see as I preview on each one of these, it does different things. And I'll just try and find one that looks like it's appropriate. Maybe the jiggle, that'll do us, I think, for this video. At least we can see it's doing something. So you see it's jiggling, and the duration it's jiggling for is 1 second. Now I want it a bit longer, I think, just so we can get a good appreciation of the effect. So maybe up that to, say, 4 seconds. Click on preview. So now it jiggles for the 4 second period. So I've got my build in, which is coming in left to right. It jiggles in the middle. So now I want it to, how I'm going to finish it. I could leave it as it is now, but I'll put a third effect in as well. Maybe confetti. No, I think this crumble's quite a good one. So we'll go with crumble. Click on crumble. And that's the third effect. So I've got three different things going on now. I'm building in left to right. I do a jiggle and then it crumbles on my third item. So on the order, you can see that that one's in its third place, but I need to now build the order to make sure they all complete and all do the actual action one after another. So I can drag these in the build order. So if I've got a complex action going on, I can change these by left clicking on the item I want and then dragging it into a different position. So for example, if I wanted the dissolve to happen second, I could drag that into that position. I don't in my case, I want it to happen as I've done it, but I also want them to automatically do their actions. So on the second item, I want that to happen after the first thing is finished. And then for the third one, I want that to happen after the second thing is finished. So now they're all joined up. I can click on preview, shows the icon coming in, does a jiggle, and then it should crumble away. So the only thing left to do in Keynote is to give our background a green screen. So we need to go up to top right hand corner again, click on format, and then where it says background, we then need to click on the little box to the right, which will allow us to pick our color. We can pick green or a blue. It will work, either will work once we open this in iMovie. So I'm just going to pick green because everybody knows about green screens. And once we're happy that the green is in position, we can then export this file. So click on file, export to. We want to export it to a movie. Make sure the resolution is set to the size that you're working with. So I'm going to be using 1080p, as I explained at the beginning of the video. Everything else looks good. I can click on next. This will then export this as a small MPEG-4 video, which I can then add to iMovie. So I'm just going to give it a name so I can find it again in a second. So coffee logo, save it into movies, click on export. Okay, so it is now exporting the movie. Then get rid of that one now. I can get rid of these. In fact, no, I'll leave Finder there for a second. So now open iMovie up. Now I've already put a file in iMovie, called it green screen. And it's, like I say, it's a video of a cup of coffee. It's a free video downloaded off the internet that is labeled for reuse. So I just wanted something with a bit of movement in. Okay, so I've got the cup of coffee here. Like I said, steaming, it's stationary camera, but with a steaming cup of coffee. So I need to add the file. So I'll just drag this onto my timeline first. So there we go. That's the video playing as it is at the moment. And I want my action for my coffee post-it note to come in from left to right. So we'll stop that, go back to the beginning. And then we need to open our Finder window up, find the picture that we have just exported, our MPEG-4 movie. So I'll drag that onto our iMovie library, minimize Finder window. So now we can see there's our small movie clip that we created. So if I left click on that and then drag it onto the top of my video file, you'll notice obviously the green screen is still there at the moment. That's because it's on top of the coffee video. So I need to get rid of the green screen. So I'll just pause that. So make sure that you have the green screen clip highlighted, indicated with a yellow border. Go up to the top menu in iMovie, click on the video overlay settings box, and then you've got another submenu with a couple of options in. We want green and blue screen. And you can see straight away that removes the green screen element of the clip and leaves our post-it note. So I'll just hit play now, and we should see the post-it note come in from the side, do its jiggle, and then dissolve away. So that's how to create an animation using Keynote on your Apple Mac, and also how to create a green screen effect in iMovie using the animation from Keynote. If you like the video, please do subscribe to my channel. Please hit the bell icon to be alerted to any new videos that I do. And any comments below are always appreciated. And thanks again for watching the Computer Lab.